So my name is Christine Letswalo, and I'm from Polokwane. Oh, okay. So just like any other woman, just like any other woman, it's our heart's desires to get married, have kids, and for our careers to go well. So in my case, it was the career, it was kids, but what was lacking was marriage. This area in my life has been a battle. I'm 35 years of age today, and as much as it was my heart's desire, I believe the enemy fought me a lot in this area. I got engaged in 2015, and so from there onwards, it was just, you know, financial troubles, it was fightings, it was, you know, one thing after the other. 2017, last year, we had our second child, a daughter, and so my mother has been with me in this journey for some time, you know, standing in the gap for me and my siblings. I've got three sisters and I've got an elder brother. I'm the eldest of the girls. So it's always been her passion, or rather her heart's desire also, for her daughters to also find marriage. So a family friend told her about Shekinah Ministries. And in June last year, we decided we were going to visit the church. As we were on our way to church, I was driving the car, and I was involved in a car accident. My kids were at the back, but we were not harmed. It was just the car that was harmed. And as you can just imagine how despondent I was, and I was asking myself, okay, is this the right church to go to? And all this thoughts came through my mind, because I just felt, you know, the enemy is definitely fighting me. There's something there. So we persisted, and we came to church on that day. So I didn't see the prophet on that day, but the service was good. So we went home, and like I said, I was despondent, and I was asking myself a lot of questions to say, you know, is this the church? Is this prophet real? Because I had been to many prophets. They had told me a lot of things, but none of them had ever come to pass. So the second time around, when I was coming to the church, I fell and I broke my knee. So once again, you know, I persisted and I came to church, and I told myself that, you know what, there's something that the enemy is definitely fighting me about. You know, like I said, it was a passion for me to, or rather a heart's desire for me to get married. And I knew that this area of my life, the devil is really fighting me on. I wanted it that much. So I continued. So I made a one-on-one appointment with a prophet. I came with my mother on that day. And the first thing that he said was to my mother that the enemy is fighting your kids in this area. And my mother obviously confirmed it. And so the prophet said to me that as I'm here, I need to stand in the gap for my siblings. So I had to fast and pray. And each time I fast and pray, three times I need to put a seed. And so we left. And on the very same day that I also came for the one-on-one, I had a work interview somewhere else, but I told myself that, you know what, I can't miss this, because I know what is at stake in my life, and I know exactly what it is that I want. So we left on that day. So I came again on the triple anointing service. And on the Saturday, the service was good. On the Sunday, Prophet Moses called me, and he said to me, "Where's your husband?" And I said, "Well, I'm not married yet." And he said, "Well, pray for this area, because this is going to happen this year." So obviously, after that, after the service, you know, the prophet even said that, you know what, the enemy is going to fight you guys, because there's greater things that are going to come out of you. A lot of people are going to come and testify, you know. And indeed, there were a lot of, you know, confusion, there was doubt, there was a whole lot of things, there was accusation from family members, so many things. But because I knew who I am in Christ, and I knew the promises that God had for me, I persisted in prayer, and I persisted on what the prophet had said. So I definitely and prayed about it, and I used the mediums as well. I anointed myself with the blood of Jesus. Every time there would be an argument in the house, I would use the salt just to anoint the house as well, just for peace, you know, because I knew that, you know, without this, if I can't do it, nobody else will do it. So just to give God the glory and honor, on the 28th of December, I got married.
Hallelujah. Can I hear some ululations, people of God? Can we clap louder? Can we scream? Indeed, our God is good, whether it is convenient for the enemy or not, whether the enemy likes it or not. When God has confirmed it, when God has declared it, it will surely come to pass. What God has put in place for you will surely be put in your hands. You will surely receive it, whether the devil likes it or not. Amen. Sister, you may continue.
So, like I said, on the 28th, we had the whole Lobola negotiations. We just had a mini traditional wedding. So I'm just basically here to say, God, I thank you. Because I turned 35 in December, and it was just part of, you know, a lot of glorious joys in my life to say, God, you did it for me. And I'm just basically here to encourage other young women to say, no matter how difficult it is, if you know the promises that you have from God, continue praying for them, continue being faithful, and God will surely come to pass for you.
Hallelujah. Can we clap louder and more beautiful, people of God? Can we make it louder and more beautiful? Amen. Indeed, our God is good. Hallelujah. Sister, can you please just tell us, we're seeing pictures on the screen. Can you please tell us what was happening here?
So that was on the day. So that's my mother there that you're seeing, and that's my uncle. He had just received some of his gifts, and that's me there and my daughter.
What was the occasion on that day?
So that was where it was the Lobola negotiation and the traditional wedding.
Amen. Hallelujah. Can we put our hands together for Master Jesus? So you said, you mentioned when you began your testimony, you mentioned that the one issue that brought you to Shekinah Glorious Faith Ministries was the issue of marriage. And you came for the one-on-one, and the man of God touched on that area. And you came for the triple anointing, and the servant of God, Apostle Moses, touched on that area. And he said that you will get married at the end of the year. And indeed, you got married in 2017. How do you feel about the word of God manifesting in your life after experiencing so many challenges?
Sure. Words can never explain how much joy I'm feeling. You know, God has done it for me. That's all I can say. It's a testimony. I've always said that I will live to testify of God's goodness and glory, and this is one of them. I'm grateful. I am so happy that finally it's happened, and I can only give God the glory.
Hallelujah. Put your hands together for Master Jesus. And sister, we're seeing a shining piece on your... Let us see the wonderful works of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We are taking over all that is ours, whether the enemy likes it or not, whether it is convenient for the enemy or not. Sister, can you please share with us a word of advice? How can you also tap into that very same anointing and same grace that you've experienced in your life?
So the question that I'd ask is that, how much do you want it? Because if you want it this much, you'll only do this much. But if you want it that much, you'll do so much. You'll wake up at 12 a.m. to pray. You'll wake up at 3 a.m. You'll fast. You'll use the spiritual mediums. No matter the negativity that comes from family members or from people, distractions come. You are able to fight with the word of God. When fear comes, you are able to say, but God has not given me the spirit of fear, but the spirit of love and peace of sound mind. When there's confusion, you will tell the enemy that God is not the author of confusion. So it helps to know the word of God. It also helps to remind God of his word. The scripture that always encouraged me was Jeremiah 29. 39, verse 11, when he said, "For I know the plans that I've got for you, and those plans are for good and not for evil." So when trouble came my way, when I felt despondent, when I felt faith, I spoke that word upon God, and I reminded him that, "Daddy, I'm your child and I'm your daughter. You can do this for me." And indeed, he has done it.
Put your hands together for Master Jesus. Amen. Our God is an awesome God. Hallelujah. Sister, we thank you very much for sharing with us your wonderful testimony and your beautiful word of advice. We pray and believe that better is not good enough for you as a child of God, but the best is yet to come. May the perfect peace of our Lord and Savior rest and abide with you and your family, both now and forevermore. Amen.
Thank you.
Put your hands together for Master Jesus.